A very good morning to one and all. I welcome you all to this online session. So here today we are going to discuss about a stationary or a standing waves. Before going to this topic, we just revise what we learned in the last class. So in the last class we discussed about the principle of superposition and reflection of wave pulse at the fixed and free ends. How a wave will behave when it reaches to the fixed end or when it reaches to the free end, how the wave behavior, that is nothing but the boundary behavior of wave pulses when it reaches to the end. So here I'll just revise. So before going to that, what is the principle of superposition? So a principle of superposition is nothing but if we have two or more than two pulses which are traveling in a medium and they overlap at an instant of time, then what is the displacement of particles of the medium at that time? That is given by the resultant displacement of particles of the medium is the algebraic sum of the displacement due to each pulse in the absence of others. So it's an algebraic sum of the displacement due to each pulses in the absence of others. Here the algebraic sum we are considering because the displacement is a vector. It may be a positive displacement or it may be a negative displacement. So for that reason we are considering algebraic sum of the displacements due to individual pulses in the absence of others. So this principle of superposition is very important in understanding the phenomena such as wave interference, where we have a constructive interference or a destructive interference. So to understand these concepts, the principle of superposition is very useful. So here let us consider the two cases. Whenever a single wave pulse which is generated in the string reaches to the fixed support. So the first figure, so here we can see here two figures. Whenever a wave pulse which is moving from right to left reaches a free end or it reaches to a fixed end. So the first figure, the vertical, all these are different instances. Whenever a wave pulse moving from right to the left and reaching the result support or reaching the free end. So here the wave pulse exert a transverse force and because of this the disturbance is moving in the medium, and when it reaches, so see here the pulse, the jerk is moving, advancing from right to left. As in when it reaches to the support, result support, result means that the particles of the medium cannot able to displace, the resultant displacement at this. So the thing is known, its result means the displacement of the particles is zero. So how it will be zero? So see here, once the pulse reaches to the result support, the displacement of the particles of the string is zero. Here what is happening is the particles of the string which is having a energy, so you have supplied energy to this end, the particles of the string are attained energy and that energy is propagated like this. Once it reaches to the end, what is happening is here the string exert force on the rigid support, and it is rigid means it's fixed, the force cannot able to displace the particles. Now as a reaction to this transverse force acting on the support, so here that force acting on the support because of the string, and now the reaction is that, so here the force is acting to move the particles in the upward direction. As a reaction, the rigid support exert force on the particles of the string in the downward direction. According to Newton's third law, for every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. So this is trying to, the string is trying to move the particles in the upward direction, and the rigid support is trying to move the particles in the downward direction. So as a result of which we'll get an inverted pulse. So here, the because of the downward force, the particle starts oscillating. Again, the energy is transferred from one particle to the other. So likewise, the disturbance is propagated. So you can see here the incident pulse and the reflected pulse, all the wave properties remain same. The amplitude, frequency, wavelength, speed, wave speed, everything is same, but the wave is gets inverted, the reflected wave is getting inverted. So it has an additional phase of pi. So here we can consider this as a incident pulse and the reflected pulse. We can consider this case as a superposition. So see here, at the rigid support, it's nothing but a positive half cycle of the incident pulse and a negative half cycle of the reflected pulse, they overlapping. So the positive displacement and the negative displacement, they are equal and cancel out, giving rise to the resultant displacement at the boundary is always zero. At the rigid support, the displacement is zero, means that it is a destructive interference. So in a destructive interference, the crust of the wave falls on a trough of the wave, giving rise to equal amplitude, opposite in directions, equal displacements, opposite in direction. So this is positive half cycle and this is negative half cycle. So at the time of overlap, these are equal and opposite, giving rise to the resultant displacement as zero. So we can consider it as a overlapping of incident and reflected waves, giving rise to a destructive interference with a zero displacement here. Now if you consider a free end, so here the arrangement is such that the one end is the string one end is free, which is can able to move, and the other end is fixed to the rod via a ring. So the string can able to move on the vertical rod. So in this case, again the wave pulse is moving from right to left. So here the wave pulse is propagating. As and when it reaches to the ring, so what happened? There is no constraint here. The ring can able to move on the vertical direct, on the vertical rod. So the string is not exerting any force on the rod. So here the string and the ring both are moving along the rod. So see here, the string and the rod both are moving. So here you have the string experiences a large tension here, and also observe that this displacement is twice that of the incident pulse. So incident pulse amplitude or the displacement is this much only, but here the wave acquires a displacement which is twice that of the incident pulse. Here what is happening? So we are going to see here. So here there is no transverse force, there is no upward force acting. So as a reaction, there is no downward force. So the wave remains the same, means here it once it enters again, it moves with the same phase here. So it's not gets inverted. The inverted wave pulse is because of the downward force, but here there is no downward force. The force is trying to move the ring and the string in the upward direction. At this instant, the string has a maximum displacement which is more than the incident pulse, and after that again the wave pulse, reflected wave pulse, is moving in the with the same phase. So with the whatever it was coming with the same, it was moving. So here positive half cycle is gets converted into negative, whereas here the positive half cycle remains positive. And one thing is, if it is the incident pulse is moving in the left, the reflected pulse is moving in the right direction. But everything is same, phase is same, wavelength is same, amplitude is same, frequency, everything is same. So here again, here also we can consider at, see here I am saying at the fourth figure, the string acquires a large displacement. This we can consider it as a overlap of incident pulse and the reflected pulse. See here, in here both are in phase, both are in phase. So if they are in phase, means that the crust falling on a crust giving rise to a maximum displacement. So here a constructive interference is taking place at this. So overlap of incident pulses which are in same phase, means crust falling on a crust momentarily, at that instant you will get a maximum displacement. So it's nothing but a constructive interference. So these are the two cases. So overlapping of incident and reflected giving rise to destructive, overlapping of incident and reflected wave pulse giving rise to a constructive interference. So depending on the nature of the support, we'll get a wave pulses reflected wave pulse may be inverted, or the reflected wave pulse will be remains same. So these things we discussed already in the last class. So here we are again revising the concepts. So also here also we can see that two cases, two half pulses. So here one pulse is positive half cycle and negative half cycle. So whenever they are moving at the boundary, so what is happening at the time of overlap? So see here, this is the region where the two waves are. So they are propagating. This positive half cycle is moving in the left, negative half cycle is moving in the right. So at the time of overlap, what is happening is, so these are two positive and negative half cycle. The displacement at the time of overlap is zero. For all these instances, the string's displacement is zero. Once this pulses after overlapping, the positive half cycle moves as it remains same, means they retains their individual identity, and the negative half cycle moves. But at the time of overlap, the displacement is given by the algebraic sum of the displacement due to each pulses. So here these are two half cycles which are moving. So we can say that this is a destructive interference. Now let us say actually this is a incident pulse and this is the reflected. So they are moving in opposite direction, everything remains same, phase everything is same. So at the time of interface, means if the time of overlap, so whenever this crust falling on a crust, so whenever a crust falling on a crust, so see here, more or less you will get a maximum displacement. Once they leaves one another, so the left pulse moving in this direction and the right pulse moving. So at the time of overlap, if the crust falling on a crust, you will get a constructive interference where the displacement is maximum. So we can consider these two cases as a superposition of incident and reflected wave pulses. Now today we are going to discuss about the stationary waves or standing waves. So we know that a traveling wave, so which is generated by vibrating this, by moving the string up and down, we can able to generate a traveling wave. And the traveling wave, once it reaches to the rigid support, what happens? So here this is the first wave which is reaching to the end. Now because of the rigid support, the wave acquires a phase, additional phase of pi. So if this is a crust, this will become trough. Now the second wave is propagating in the negative x direction. Again the third wave, here there is, it's a free end. So if it is a free end, the wave pulse have not suffered any phase change. So observe here, in a reflected wave pulse, if it is a rigid support, the reflected wave pulse have an additional phase of pi. an additional phase of pi. Whereas in a free end, the reflected wave pulse, see here, this is the incident and it attains a additional phase, inverted means it's a pi phase. Here this is the incident and the reflected is also same, means the phase change in a free end is zero, the phase change in a fixed support is pi. So here also, as and when it reaches for a rigid support, the wave acquires an additional phase pi, so crust will become trough. Now it reaches to the free end, the crust remains the crust. So here if you have a traveling wave moving in the positive x direction and negative x direction, so if they overlap each other, how the wave pattern, what will be the resultant displacement of the particles of the medium? So that's we are going to see now. So here these are the one end is fixed and one end is free. Suppose in a musical instruments, both the ends are fixed. So we have, so here the one boundary, but in a musical instruments or in a rail air column where we have more than one boundary. So in that case, if we have a fixed, if we have a string which is fixed at both the ends, and if you generate a traveling wave which is traveling in the positive x direction, and after reflecting from the end it moves in the negative x direction. So here for the incident and the reflected waves, both have the same amplitude, same wavelength, same frequency, but it has a, one is moving along x direction, positive x direction, and another moving along negative x direction. So now we are going to write a two traveling waves which are moving in opposite direction with the same amplitude, frequency, wavelength. So the traveling wave equation, displacement equation for a wave traveling along a positive x direction is given by, actually we have to write it as A sine kx minus omega t plus phi. That is the general expression for a traveling wave moving along positive x direction. Suppose you are assuming the initial phase angle is zero, means that at the time of observation, the wave may be at, the particle may be at the extreme or at the mean position. And similarly, a traveling wave which is moving along negative x direction, simply in a negative x direction, we have to write it as the displacement equation as, we have to write the displacement equation as A sine kx plus omega t plus phi, but initially itself we are taking the initial phase angle is zero. So the displacement of particle which is moving along a positive x direction is A sine kx minus omega t. And the reflected wave which is moving opposite to the incident wave, negative x direction, is nothing but A sine kx plus omega t. Now the displacement, so overlapping of these two waves, so and the in the region, these incident and the reflected wave pulses overlap. So what is the resultant displacement because of these two waves traveling in opposite direction? So that is given by the principle of superposition. So the resultant displacement is sum of the displacements of each pulses. So A sine kx minus omega t plus A sine kx plus omega t. Remember, both the waves have same amplitude, same frequency, same wavelength, but one is moving along x, positive x direction, and another is moving along negative x direction. Now using the trigonometric formula, we can calculate the resultant displacement as 2a sine kx multiplied by cos omega t. So this is the resultant displacement. So initially we consider it two traveling waves. We consider it two traveling waves, and after overlapping, and means by applying the at the time of overlap, the resultant displacement is given by this. So this is a standing wave function, the wave equation for a standing waves. We know The wave function for a traveling wave is A sine kx minus omega t, where x indicates the location of the particle and t indicates the vibration of the particle. So we require each particle, the location of each particle and the vibration of that particle, which gives rise to a wave. So how it spreads in a space, x gives rise to, suppose if you fix a time, if you fix a time at an instant of time, it gives the shape of the wave, snapshot of the wave. And if you fix a time, you can get the particle vibration. We already discussed where we have A sine kx minus omega t. If I fix time, the wave equation gives rise to how the particles are spread in space. Suppose if fix a time, that gives, suppose if you fix a position x, it gives rise to how the particles is vibrating. So it simultaneously have the information about how a wave spread in space and how the particles are vibrating. In a traveling wave, all this information is there, A sine kx minus omega t. Kx, x indicates how a wave spreads, t indicates how a particle vibrates. But this is something different than that of the traveling wave. So here we have kx and omega t terms separately, not in a combined form. In a traveling wave, we have kx term and omega term, both are in a combined form, kx minus omega t, but they are separated here. So we can consider this equation as simply a particle which is making a simple harmonic motion. So what is the displacement equation for a particle making simple harmonic motion? Simply y is equals to a cos omega t. So here we have something called 2a sin kx. We can consider it as a the amplitude and a cos omega t. Means that here the wave is not moving with the time, the wave remains there itself. Here cos omega t indicates what? The particles which are making an oscillations or vibration. It doesn't have how is the wave spread in space? No. Here omega t indicate how the particles are oscillating. We can consider this equation as y. We can compare this equation with the displacement of a particle executing SHM. So y is equal to a cos omega t, means that this term is the amplitude and this indicates the particle vibration. So here also superposition of two traveling waves gives rise to a displacement which is similar to a particle making simple harmonic motion. So here we don't have a separate terms. It shows that, so see here, is this 2a sin kx. As x changes, this term 2a sin kx changes. Means that it doesn't have a constant amplitude. For a simple harmonic motion, we have a constant amplitude. But here, in a standing wave, the amplitude changes with the time. The amplitude of the particles changes with position x. From point to point, the amplitude changes. Whereas in a single particle, the amplitude remains same. So it's something different what we have to understand. So 2a sin kx cos omega t. Now just observe here, the green color indicates a traveling wave moving in the positive x direction. And a blue color wave after reflection from the rigid support, it is, so see here, this green color wave, it is having a trough. So here we have a trough because these two are out of phase, right? After passing through a rigid support, the reflected wave pulse has a phase of additional phase of pi. So if this is a trough, it is a crust. So it is moving in the reverse direction. So here they are overlapping because these are the traveling waves, means they are not remain same, they are always in motion. So here we can observe, so this is moving, the blue color is moving towards left and green color is moving towards right. What is this red color? That indicates according to the principle of superposition, if these two waves are overlapping in a string, in the medium of string, what is the resultant displacement, which is given by the principle of superposition. So here observe slowly the amplitude, red color, observe the red color wave pulse, the resultant displacement because of the two traveling waves. So the amplitude, initially the amplitude is this much. Now the amplitude is increasing, and further that amplitude is increasing. Why? Because, so here the blue color and the green color shows the incident and reflected wave pulses. So here this is moving in the downward, and this is more, maybe these two are having a positive displacement. They have the positive displacement y1 and y2. Let us say y1, y2 are the displacement due to each pulses. So they both are in the positive direction. And see here, the displacement is goes on increasing. So here, from the mean position, the displacement is maximum because these two are having a positive displacement, and they are slowly coming in such a way that the crust is falling on a crust. So slowly these traveling waves are moving in such a way that they are trying to come in phase. In phase means the crust falling on. So here there is a phase change. Now this is a crust and this is a crust. So these are the points of same phase. As in when they approach, means that the two waves are in phase. In that case, constructive interference takes place. You will get a maximum displacement here. So here, once they are moving, traveling waves are moving at one particular. So here the amplitude of the resultant wave is goes on increasing. Once these two wave pulses are overlapping in such a way that crust falling on a crust, further the amplitude increases. Then what happens next? So again, so once they come to in phase, constructive interference takes place, you will get a maximum amplitude. Again, these two waves are overlapping in such a way that the crust falling on a trough, or a crust trough falling on a crust, means that they are in out of phase. Means that the displacements are equal and opposite, so they cancel each other. So again, the resultant displacement will become zero. So this is the resultant wave form. It changes with the time. It will not be remain same, but with the time, as in when these two traveling waves moves, if they move in such a way that a crust falls on crust, you will get a constructive interference with a maximum amplitude. A trough falling on a trough also gives rise to a constructive interference. But other thing, if a crust on a trough or a trough on a crust, if they fall, they are out of phase, giving rise to a destructive interference. That we are going to see in a detailed way. Just observe this animation, it will come. So here the wave pattern is neither moving to the right, nor, because by seeing the wave equation, we can say that the displacement equation 2a sin kx cos omega t, with the time the wave pattern is not changing, it remains there. So it shows that it is called a stationary or a standing wave. So all these things. So if a two traveling waves moves in opposite direction, let us say at an instant of time, these two wave pulses, crust falling on a crust, giving rise to a maximum displacement. So once if you have a constructive interference, both are having same amplitude. Incident wave pulse and reflected wave pulse have same amplitude, but they are equal amplitude and they are in phase. So the displacement will become 2a. A plus a will become 2a. So again, so if the two traveling waves, wave patterns which are moving in such a way that the crust falling on a trough, so in that case, if they are out of phase, they are becoming out of phase, so the displacements equal and they cancel out, giving rise to the wave pattern displacement will become zero. So at a node, the displacement of the two waves are equal, out of phase and cancel, giving rise to a destructive interference. So the points where the displacement is zero is called a node. In a wave pattern, if the two waves are overlapped in such a way that the two waves are out of phase, so the displacement will become zero, those points we call it as nodes. And in between the nodes, If the two waves are overlapping in phase, both are having an amplitude A. So if they are overlapping, giving rise to a constructive interference with a large amplitude, that is 2A. Now observe this. So the waves, if they are moving, red color which is moving towards the right and blue is moving towards the left, and the black color indicates the resultant of these two traveling waves which are moving in the opposite direction. Observe here, whenever these two waves are overlapping in phase, you will get a maximum amplitude. And so it's repeating this pattern in a regular intervals of time. So once crust falling on crust, maximum amplitude. After that, once crust falling on trough, zero amplitude. Again, trough falling on trough, maximum amplitude. So the amplitude is moving up and down. So that is the, see, and also observe that the amplitude of the standing wave pattern is 2 times that of the incident wave pulse. So now here carefully we can observe these things. So let us say at a time of t by 16, for a time period where t is nothing but a time period. So here the pink color indicates the wave traveling in the left side direction and the blue indicates the wave traveling in the right side direction. So here now after a time of t by 4, for t by 16 nothing but t by 4. So how the waves are, just observe the crust, the maximum of the first wave and second wave, they are in phase, they are in phase. So in that case, the crust falling on a crust, so these are the instant of time. At this instant of time, the crusts of two waves or the troughs of two waves are in phase. So here you will get a maximum amplitude. Now the same location after a time of t by 2, what is happening? So the left side wave crust falling on a trough. So here at the same location, this here more or less these two are the waves which are traveling in the mean position, so the displacement will be zero. Now coming to here, the crust falling on trough, so the displacement will become zero. So it repeats. So for a time period of t by 4, the two waves are in phase, giving rise to a constructive interference with a maximum amplitude. And after a time of t by 2, these two waves are interfering in such a way that the crust falling on a trough means they are out of phase, giving rise to destructive interference with a zero amplitude. Again, it repeats. So here, these are the positions where the particles, where the wave pulses are in phase, giving rise to a maximum displacement. Those positions, we call it as antinodes. Again, we are repeating the same thing. So antinodes. So here, how to know the position of nodes and antinodes? So what is the wave equation for a standing wave? Standing wave equation is y is equals to 2a sin kx cos omega t. So when it will become 0, y is equals to 0, if suppose 2a sin kx, suppose if sin kx is 0, so obviously the entire equation will become 0. So sin kx, sin of something, sin of the angles, when it will become 0 for an angle of 0 and for an angle of pi and for an angle of 2 pi, for an angle of 3 pi, for all these the sin value will become 0. So means that kx is equals to n pi, means that it may be 0, 1 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, for all these values of angle the sin value will be 0. And we know that k, wave vector k, is equals to 2 pi by lambda. So substituting here, x will become n lambda by 2, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. So at these positions of the string, you have a nodes where the displacement is 0. So suppose if n is equal to 0, means that at the fixed ends, obviously we have a nodes. There is no displacement of the particles. Yes, it's clamped, it's fixed. And one more thing is that in between the string also we can observe a zero displacement position. We are not fixed or we are not clamped in between the strings, but because of the overlapping at some regions in between the string also you have nodes with a zero displacement. Those are the difference. If we fix the ends of the string, yes, obviously there is no displacement of the strings. You have to get zero displacement. But in between also, because of the destructive interference, you will get a points where the displacement is zero. So it's just like we have not clamped actually. It shows that in between the string also, there is a constraint or the string is clamped. It behaves like that. So what is the distance between two successive nodes? So suppose for the at the end we have a node and for n equal to 1, so lambda by 2. So what is the distance between two nodes, consecutive nodes? It is lambda. 0, lambda 2 is the distance between two consecutive nodes. Right. Now, what is the positions of antinodes? Antinodes means what? When two wave pulses traveling in opposite direction in such a way that the crust falling on a crust means if the two waves are in phase, crust falling on a crust or trough falling on a trough, where both have the same amplitude A, they overlap giving rise to a displacement of maximum displacement of 2A, constructive interference takes place. So when will become the displacement maximum? So 2A sin kx indicates amplitude term. When it will become maximum? So here I consider because amplitude is a positive, but displacement may be a positive or a negative. So what is an amplitude, maximum amplitude? So modulus, I consider modulus of sine kx, because sine varies from minus 1 to plus 1. So what are the different values of sine kx such that the displacement will become maximum? It may be a positive or it may be a negative. So here when will become cos kx 1, sorry, sin kx 1. So sin pi by 2 1, sin 3 pi by 2 minus 1, sin 5 pi by 2 plus 1. So likewise, so here if you consider modulus, always the sin value will become 1. So kx is equals to n. So for the values of, so n equal to 0 pi by 2, n equal to 1 3 pi by 2, n equal to 2 5 pi by 2. So for all these values of angle, the sine value will become 1. So here kx is equal to n plus 1 by 2 into, for all values of half in odd multiples of lambda by odd multiples of pi by 2. Pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, 7 pi by 2. For all these angles, sine value will become 1. And modulus, if you consider modulus, if it may be 1 or minus 1, it will become 1. So x is equal to n plus half into lambda by 2. By using the for k is equals to 2 pi by lambda, substituting here, we'll get x is equal to n plus half into lambda by 2. So what is the, when the first antinode forms, suppose if I substitute n equal to 0, so it will become lambda by 4. The other consecutive node, antinode will be, suppose n equal to 1, it will become 3 lambda by 4. So lambda by 4, 3 lambda by 4, likewise 5 lambda by 4. For all these positions, we have antinodes. So what is the distance between two consecutive nodes? It is also lambda by 2. 3 lambda by 4 minus lambda by 4, we'll get it as lambda by 4. So the distance between two consecutive nodes or a distance between two consecutive antinodes is always lambda by 2. So here what we can see is, in a traveling wave, if you consider a traveling wave where the wave is propagating, transporting energy from one end to the other, whereas in a standing wave the wave remains there, the wave pattern is not moving with the time, it remains there. But what is happening is, here in a in phase, if the wave pulses are in phase, the amplitude will become, instead of A, the amplitude is 2A. and out of phase, even though the incident and the reflected wave pulse amplitudes are AA, the amplitude is becoming zero. So one way the amplitude zero and the another it is 2A. So here whatever missing in the destructive interference out of phase, that is appearing in the constructive interference. So the energy is propagated from node to an antinode. It's not moving from one end of the string to the other end, but it's a local flow of energy from node to an antinode or from antinode to node. So here the energy is localized. The energy is not transmuting from one end of the string to the other end, but it is flowing. So node, where we have zero displacement, so energy is zero. Antinode, where we have a maximum amplitude, so at that time the energy is maximum there. After that, this will nodes and antinode locations changes, correspondingly the energy, so the energy is shared between the adjacent nodes and antinodes, but it is not transferring. So average rate of flow of energy will become zero in case of a standing waves. So just we are trying to compare the traveling wave and the standing wave. So observe here, in a traveling wave, the amplitude remains same. The wave amplitude remains same. So see here, the amplitude same. And the wave pulse is propagating, transporting energy. Whereas in a case of a standing wave, see here, the amplitude of the standing wave is zero. The amplitude is maximum. The amplitude is zero. So, and at this location, see here, the amplitude is continuously changing. Whereas here, amplitude of the wave remains same in case of a traveling wave. So, observe here, this is a dotted line. So one time you will get this solid line, and the other time you will get this. The standing wave pattern may not be, because if we consider a high frequency, it just appears that it's a loop-like structure. The standing wave pattern is like a loop-like structure. Actually, this forms, after certain time, it continues. So likewise, it moves, giving rise to the pattern is standing. So the location, so he see here, the location of the particles of the string here will have a same amplitude. So the amplitude of is fixed. The amplitude of the particles of the string is fixed. The amplitude of the particles of the string located at this position is fixed. So here the amplitude is different for different particles, whereas here the amplitude of all the particles remains same. If the particles which are making simple harmonic oscillation, the amplitude of the particle remains same, whereas here each and every particle will have a constant amplitude and is different from that of the adjacent particle. So that is the difference. So by seeing itself, it is propagating. The amplitude remains constant in the case of a traveling. It is propagating from one place to another. And the amplitude of the wave remains same. Whereas by seeing this standing wave pattern, the amplitude of the wave is not constant. The amplitude here is zero. So likewise, each and every particle amplitude is different. And all the standing wave pattern also moves with the same frequency. Frequency remains same, but amplitude of different particles will be different. So that we are trying to compare a traveling wave and the standing wave. In a traveling wave, the disturbance produced in a region propagates with a definite velocity. So we know that once the disturbance is created, so it is given to the adjacent particle, it starts oscillating, giving to the adjacent particle. Likewise, the energy is propagated. In a standing wave, the disturbance is confined to the region where it is produced. So once this overlapping takes place, whenever a constructive interference, destructive interference takes place, giving rise to a standing wave pattern, it confined, it stands there itself, it's not moving in any direction. So here the particles are moving a simple harmonic motion. Here particles are also making simple harmonic motion. Here, all particles have the same amplitude, nothing but the amplitude of the wave. So, all particles have the same amplitude, nothing but the amplitude of the wave. But here, the particle amplitude is different depending on the location of the particle. So, for a particle which is here, the amplitude is this much. For a particle which is here, the amplitude is. So, this is a point called antinode where the amplitude is maximum. So, amplitude is different for different particles. But coming to the frequency, both the traveling wave and standing wave have the same frequency. Whatever the frequency, standing, how the standing wave is formed? Overlapping of incident and reflected. So, the frequency of the standing wave is same as that of the incident or the reflected wave pulse. So, here, transport of energy in phases. So, here, the wave if you consider, see, these are the particles of the string. So, here, the particle which is located here is having a x maximum amplitude, maximum displacement. So, it is at the extreme position. So, at the extreme position, the displacement is maximum, velocity is zero, acceleration is maximum. And coming to the adjacent particle, so now the particle is has a velocity, it has a displacement and acceleration. So, here on the string, the phase means it describes everything about the particle. So, this point of the string will have one particular phase and this point of the string will have one particular phase. So, the energy whatever given is transported via in different phases. So, one phase to other phase. As the energy propagates, the particle moves from one phase to the other phase. So, wave propagation is nothing but transport of energy in phases. So, each and every particle will have different phases. They don't have a same phase. But here, the particles in a standing wave, the particles will have, so see here, this is having a maximum displacement and the particle which is here, it is also having maximum displacement. So, these are nothing but the corresponding points. Once the particle reaches here, it's having a maximum displacement and whereas for the adjacent particles, the displacement is also maximum. So, these are nothing but the corresponding points. So, means that the particles phases remain same. The phases are locked. So, traveling wave in which the amplitude of the particles is constant. Whereas in a standing wave, the amplitude of the particles is different. Here, the phase is changing from particle to particle as the wave propagates. Whereas here, all the particles, so this is the maximum displacement of the particles, maximum. So, all are the corresponding point means that they have the same phase, means the phase of all the particles remains same. So, they are not transporting any energy. So, traveling wave in which the a particle is vibrating, making to and fro oscillation, the particle have all possible displacements starting from 0 to a maximum displacement of A. But in case of a standing wave, the displacement is constant, means amplitude is constant. For that particle, the amplitude remains same. It won't change. The displacement is same. So, here in traveling wave, all particles get all possible displacement. Each particle has a fixed displacement, nothing but each particle depending on the location x, 2a sin kx. So, the amplitude is fixed. X is fixed. For a particle, x is fixed, amplitude is fixed. If x changes, means particle changes, amplitude changes. Whereas here, for all the particles, the amplitude remains same. So, this is the differences between a traveling wave and a standing wave. So, in the next class, we are trying to understand about a normal modes. Normal modes. So, if you have a string which is fixed at both the ends, so you can have a mode of vibration with a one loop, a mode of vibration with a two loops, a mode of vibrations with a three loops, four loops, five loops, like this. So, see here, this is a antinode. In a figure, it's showing a loop with a positive and negative. But actually what happens is, initially you will get a positive half cycle. After that, it will get a negative half cycle. But as the frequency is very fast, you can at a time see a complete loop like this. But actually continuously the wave is changing. So you can see that in the animation. So it appears like this. Actually the black wave is the resultant of the standing wave. It's not like a loop. If the frequency is large, and frequency large means the number of wave pulses which are generating in a second. So if the wave frequency is large, in that case it's just like a standing. For a low frequency, we can able to differentiate how the standing wave is. The standing wave is like this. As and when if the wave pulses are moving very fast, if the wave pulses are moving very fast, so the wave pattern appears as like a standing wave with a fixed standing wave with a fixed point. So antinode positions where two wave pulses are in phase. So one time it is a in phase, crust falling on a crust and trough falling on a trough. So constructive interference. And so simply the standing waves are nothing but the superposition of two waves, giving rise to constructive and destructive interferences. So don't assume that this is the wave pattern. Actually the wave pattern is changing. If you consider a high frequency, it just appears like a loop structure. And also assume here at the ends we fixed, but in between the string also there are a few points where the displacement is zero. It appears that the string is also fixed at this location, but actually we are not fixed the string in between, only we fixed at the ends. But because of the out of phase or the destructive interference, the nodes are forming where the displacement will become zero. So in next class we are going to discuss about the normal modes of vibrations in a string. So in a musical instruments where we find the ends of the string is fixed, if you pluck or bow the string, the waves are generated which are reaching the other end and gets reflected back. So again they are reflected back. So likewise the incident and reflected wave pulses overlap, giving rise to a standing wave patterns. Thank you very much. Stay at home, stay safe. Thank you.